yard, which of course is underwater there, and a lot of homes and businesses as well. You can see, you know, trailers, cars, everything underwater.
Just finished, or some cases haven't even finished rebuilding after Hurricane Ike, and seeing this repeated pattern, it all helps it.
Okay, and these are roads, we can't hear where the power lines are, and of course, there's the graveyard right there, that's the water tower. Everything's underwater right there. And pretty much, you know, we have 30 minutes of video, we can't show it all to you, but majority of what we saw in Galveston, around Central Park, all underwater. Right here is, this is the Galveston.
It's kind of hard to tell when we're seeing the roads, but what you're really looking at there, in many cases, all of those, we just consider completely underwater.
This right here would be Highway 14 going to, if we were going from Galveston to New Iberia, and as you can see, it's just a river.
And it's gonna take a while before that, here we are, that's at the port, that's at the port of Iberia right there, which is used for some water, but certainly not that much.
Exactly, this right here is a road behind the port, and residences there, trailers, homes.
And we're saying businesses, there are businesses, we understand one on the body, WPS, surrounded by water islands, and there's the water, you know.
And what happened again with this storm, the water's also affecting more than Highway 14 corridor, so still back on the flood, and the trees haven't cleared the track, but very close to what we're doing in Iberia.
Right, and then we'll talk a little bit later about an accident that happened in New Iberia, and here we can hear with the bar from the Grand Dock 82 right there, shut that road, and that bridge completely down, and then there's a couple more flood right here, as you can see underwater.
Yeah, took a little more, the water got up.